क्वेश्चन नंबर 15 फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग इंफॉर्मेशन प्रिपेयर कंपेरेटिव स्टेटमेंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस शोइंग इंक्रीज डिक्रीज एंड परसेंटेज. ओके सो कॉस्ट ऑफ मटेरियल कंज्यूम्ड इज गिवन, रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन इज गिवन, इट इज परसेंटेज ऑफ मटेरियल कंज्यूम्ड. गुड क्वेश्चन. अदर एक्सपेंसेज इट इज परसेंटेज ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग रेवेन्यू एंड देन टैक्स रेट इज 50% इन बोथ द केसेस. सो करेंट ईयर इज गिवन एंड प्रीवियस ईयर इज गिवन. वी नीड टू प्रिपेयर कंपेरेटिव स्टेटमेंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस. सो लेट मी स्टार्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 15. कंपेरेटिव स्टेटमेंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस particulars, then previous year we write first, then we write current year, then absolute change will come, and then percentage change will come. So let's begin. From where we begin? We begin from revenue from operations. Revenue from operations. So let's see what value is given. Value is not given. Revenue from operation percentage is given. So children, here it is given 200%. So what is the 200% of 6 lakh?
12 lakhs.
Yes. 12 lakh. Very good. So let's calculate for current year. So it is given 13,44,000. You need to compute 125%. And 125% means 5 by 4. Yes or no? 125% means 5 by 4. So calculate.
Yes, sir.
13,44,000 into 5 by 4.
16,80,000.
Okay, very good. 16,80,000. So, other incomes are not given. So, this is your total income, revenue from operation. 12 lakh of previous year. You can write with me, na? Simultaneously, if you write, na, then it saves your time. So this is your total income. A. Okay. Then let's see about expenses. What is given? Cost of material consumed and other expenses, two are given. So cost of material consumed is 6 lakh and 13,44,000. Cost of material consumed in previous year it is 6 lakh and in current year it is 13,44,000. Then something else is given, that is other expenses. 10% of operating revenue. What does it mean? It means 10% of revenue from operation. Hai na, here. Other expenses. 10% of 12 lakh is 1,20,000.
1,20,000.
And 10% of 16,80,000 is
1,68,000.
Let's do the total. Okay. 6 plus 1, 7. 7,20,000. 13 plus 1, 14. 14 and 60 plus 40, 15. 15,12,000. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this is total expenses. Very, very simple, dear children. What will come when we subtract B minus A. What we get?
Profit before tax.
A minus B. So 12 minus 7, 5 lakh. 5 lakh minus 20,000, 4 lakh 80,000. है ना? फिर 16 लाख माइनस 15 लाख 1 लाख एंड 80,000 माइनस 12,000 68,000 सो 1 लाख 68,000 इज इट करेक्ट? यस
यस सो
इज करेक्ट. देन अगेन वी सबट्रैक्ट. व्हाट वी सबट्रैक्ट? टैक्स. व्हाट इज द रेट ऑफ टैक्स? लेट्स चेक. द रेट ऑफ टैक्स इज 50%. So let's calculate. 50% of 48,000 is 24,000. Isn't it?
24,000.
Sir, 2,40,000. 2,40,000. Acha, sorry, it is 4,80,000, na? Yes, it is 4,80,000. 2,40,000. 2,40,000 and 1,68,000, 50% of it?
84,000.
Correct. Then subtract. It become 2,40,000. It become 84,000. Simple. Now we need to calculate absolute change and percentage change. Absolute change, how do we calculate? Current year minus previous year. Hai na? So 16,80,000 minus 12 lakh.
4,80,000.
Correct. 4,80,000. Then 13 minus 6, 7. So
7,44,000.
Correct. 68 minus 20.
48,000.
Correct. Then 15,12,000 minus 7,20,000.
7,92,000.
Correct. Then 1,68,000 minus 4,80,000.
Sir, 3,12,000 negative.
3,12,000 negative. So we will put bracket for negative elements. 84,000 minus 2,40,000.
Negative 1,56,000.
1,56,000 negative. Okay, very good. And it is also coming negative 1,56,000. Let us calculate percentage. So 4,80,000 divided by 12,00,000, 40%. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
12,4 is 48. Simple. Hana? You can also calculate so easily. Now 7,44,000 divided by 6,00,000. This is, I think you need to calculate. Calculate.
Sir,
124%.
124%. 124%. Then again, 48,000 divided by 1,20,000.
40%.
Correct. 7,92,000 divided by 7,20,000.
110%.
312,000 divided by 4,80,000. Calculate.
Sir, 65%.
Minus.
65% negative. It means 65% negative. It means 65% and negative. All these three always remain same together. So no need to calculate. If you calculate also, you will get the same figure. This is what percentage change. You can easily calculate by this formula. Absolute change divided by previous year multiply by 100. So I hope this question is clear to everyone. Question number 16. This question was the part of CBSE 2020 last year paper, है ना? So very good question. अब आप बताइए ऐसे question CBSE में आ रहे हैं, students कैसे 100% marks नहीं लाएंगे? Definitely. But still I am telling you 90% students fail to solve these questions in examination. Huh? 90% students, but nothing is there. Okay, so let's continue. Prepare a comparative statement of profit and loss. Current year and previous year is given. Revenue from operation, purchase of stock in trade, changes in inventory, other expenses and other income. 5 items are given. We need to prepare comparative statement of profit and loss. Question number 16. So here we go. Comparative statement of profit and loss. Comparative statement of profit and loss. Okay. Particulars. We write previous year first and then we write current year. Then absolute change will come. And then percentage change will come. Okay. So let's begin. Begin with revenue from operations. How much it is given? Let's see. Question number 16. It is given 40 lakh and 50 lakh. 40 lakh and 50 lakh. Then purchase of, then other income is also given here. 2 lakh and 2 lakh 50 thousand. Other income. 2 lakh and 2 lakh 50 thousand. Let's do the total, है ना? अच्छा, nobody will answer, है ना? Only those will answer to whom I will ask this time. Anya, are you there? So Anya, can you add 40 lakh plus 2 lakh?
Yes sir, 42 lakh.
42 lakh, very good. And 50 lakh plus 2 lakh 50 thousand?
52 lakh 50 thousand.
52 lakh 50 thousand, very good. Then what we do, we write expenses. Hai na? So under expenses heading, let's see how many expenses are given. Under expenses heading, 3 expenses are given. Purchase of stock in trade. Purchase of stock in trade. It is given 30 lakh and 40 lakh. 30 lakh. And 40 lakh, fine. And then changes in inventory, 8 lakh and 10 lakh. Changes in inventory, 8 lakh and 10 lakh. Okay. And then what is given? Other expenses, 4 lakh and 5 lakh. Other expenses, 4 lakh and 5 lakh. Let's do the total. Abhilasha, do the total for previous year.
Yes, sir. The 42 lakh.
Very good. 42 lakh. Homita, do the total for current year.
Sir, 55 lakh.
55 lakh. Very nice. Then what we get? Total income we give A, and this total expenses we assign
profit B. Before tax.
Yes.
Total expenses.
Total expenses when we subtract. So we get profit before tax. Remember, dear children, in this way we need to arrange properly all these values. We need to prepare a statement of profit and loss in this manner. A minus B. This is proper presentation, right? So 42 lakh minus 42 lakh.
Zero.
Correct. Then 52 lakh, 50,000 minus 55 lakh.
2 lakh 50,000.
Minus 2 lakh.
Minus 2 lakh 50,000. It is loss. It is not profit. So it means loss. We will not write profit before tax, huh? Or we can write because it is negative here. So it is loss 2,50,000. Hai na? Is tax rate given? Tax rate is not given. It is not.
No, sir.
If tax rate would be given, then also there is no use of tax rate, because tax is payable only on income.
Tax on profit.
On profit, not loss. Even if in examination tax rate will be given, then don't touch it. Don't use it. Don't calculate any tax. There is no tax on loss. But I think there should be tax on losses. Right? So people will force to earn more. Chalo, leave
it. It's an amazing idea.
It's an amazing idea. There must be some punishment. Those who fail to earn, they must pay tax. If you want to pay less tax, earn more and more. So this should be what a... There is opposite of this scenario. Those who are earning, we are taking tax from them, more and more tax. And those who are not earning, we are giving subsidies to them. Don't earn. We are giving subsidies. We are making planning. We are opening ration shop. Why you are worrying for earning? There are many PDS shops. You can get 1 rupee kilo rice, 2 rupee kilo wheat, है ना? Why you are earning? So let's continue. Absolute change means current year minus previous year. 50 lakh minus 40 lakh.
10,000.
10,000. Wow.
10 lakh. Sorry, 10 lakh.
10 lakh. Be very very attentive. Accident हो जाएगा नहीं तो. Yes. 2,50,000 divided by, sorry, minus 2 lakh. 10 lakh minus 8 lakh.
2 lakh.
5 lakh minus 4 lakh.
1 lakh.
Correct. 55 lakh minus 42 lakh.
13 lakh.
Correct. Now we need to 2,50,000 minus 2 lakh minus nil.
2,50,000.
Sir, minus 2,50,000. Isn't it? Then you need to calculate percentage change. So 10 lakh divided by 40 lakh. Absolute.
25.
Divided by previous.
25%.
10 by 40, 1 by 4, 25%. 50,000 divided by 2 lakh. 1 by 4.
Sir, 25%.
Now percentage, to calculate percentage becomes so easy. है ना, मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम. देन 10,50,000 डिवाइड बाय 42 लाख,
25%.
राइट, वेरी राइट. 10 लाख डिवाइड बाय 30 लाख,
33.33.
And then 2 lakh divided by 8 lakh,
25%.
And then 1 lakh divided by 4 lakh.
25%.
1 by 4 means 25%. Very good. Then you can calculate total 13 divided by 42. 13 lakh divided by 42 lakh.
30.95%.
30.95, huh?
Yes, sir.
30.95%. And here profit before tax is nil. है ना, सो देर इज नो, वी कैनॉट कंपेयर ना, परसेंटेज ग्रोथ वी कैनॉट कैलकुलेट एंड देर इज लॉस ऑल्सो, है ना, सो वी कैन लीव दिस पॉइंट. आई होप दिस क्वेश्चन इज क्लियर टू एवरी वन. एनी डाउट, एनी डाउट, टेल मी.
नो सर.
रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन इज गिवन, इट इज सेल्स, इट इज नॉट परचेज, है ना. We need purchase, but purchase is not given. Sorry, this is change in inventory is opening stock minus closing stock. And this is change in inventories, and purchase is not given directly. So we can take cost of material consumed. So cost of material consumed, cost of material consumed plus change in inventory, 8 + 4, 12 lakh. Will be cost of goods sold, and 6 + 2, 8 lakh. 8 lakh will be cost of revenue from operation for 2020 and for 21, 12 lakh. So we need to remember this point. Is it clear? Hai na? Let me solve this question once again for all of you. Question number 17. Question number 17, comparative statement of profit and loss. Comparative statement of profit and loss, particulars. First we write previous year value, then we write current year value, then we write absolute change, and then we write percentage change. Okay, so we start with revenue from operation. Revenue from operations, let's see how much it is given. 16 lakh and 20 lakh. Okay, 16 lakh in previous year and 20 lakh in current year. Then is other income given? Yes, other income is given, 3 lakh and 4 lakh 40,000. Other income. Let's see how much other income is given. It is given 3 lakh and 4 lakh 40,000. 3 lakh 4 lakh 40,000. Now what we do? We do total. Do the total. 16 plus 3. 19 lakh. 20 plus 4. 24 lakh 40,000. So this is our total income. Total income. which we normally give assign as A. Then what we need to write? We need to write expenses. What expenses are given? Cost of material consumed 6 lakh 8 lakh. Cost of material consumed 6 lakh and 8 lakh. And then what is given? Changes in inventories 2 lakh and 4 lakh. Changes in inventories 2 lakh and 4 lakh. Okay. And then other expenses. Okay. So other expenses is 10% of 8 lakh, 6 plus 2, 8, hai na? 6 plus 2, 8 lakh. So other expenses is cost of revenue from operation, and cost of revenue from operation means here in this question, cost of material consumed plus change in inventory. So when we add these two and what we get, we need to calculate 10% and 15%. So 10% of 8 lakh is other expense for 20. Other expense 80,000, 10% of 8 lakh. I hope it is clear to everyone. And here 8 plus 4, 12 lakh. So 15% of 12 lakh. So 12 lakh ka 15%, 1,80,000. Hai na? So 1,80,000 other expenses. 1,80,000 other expenses. Any other expenses given? No, all expenses are over. Only tax rate is given 30%. So let us do the total. Chaliye, do the total. 6,7,8,8,80,000 total expenses of previous year. 8,4,12,1,13. 13,80,000 is total expense of current year. So total expenses we will assign B. Then when we subtract A minus B, what we get? Profit before tax, hai na? A minus B, let's subtract. 19 minus 8, 11, 11 lakh minus 80,000, 10,20,000. Is it clear? Then 24,40,000 minus 1380. Solve it.
Ten lakh sixty thousand.
Okay. This is profit before tax. Then what we need to do? We need to subtract tax, and rate of tax is 30%. So calculate 30% of 10,20,000. 3,06,000. Is it correct? 3,06,000.
Yes, sir.
And here 3,18,000, 6,3,18, 10,3, है ना? 10,000 का 30% 3,00,000 है ना? ठीक है. Let me subtract and we get profit after tax. What we get? Profit after tax. So 20 minus 6, 14,000. 10 minus 3, 7,14,000. 60 minus 18, 42,000. 10 minus 3, 7,42,000. Let us calculate absolute change. Absolute change means current year minus previous year. Hai na? तो 20 लाख माइनस 16 लाख
4 लाख
4 लाख करेक्ट. देन 4,40,000 माइनस 3 लाख
1,40,000
1,40,000 देन 24,40,000 माइनस 19 लाख
5,40,000
5,40,000 गुड. 8 लाख माइनस 6 लाख
2 लाख
2 लाख 4 लाख माइनस 2 लाख
2 लाख
2 लाख 1,80,000 माइनस 80,000
1 लाख
13 लाख माइनस 8 लाख 5 लाख है ना. 10,60,000 माइनस 10,20,000
40,000
18 माइनस 6
12,000
है ना.
सॉरी सर 12,000
हाँ. एंड 42 माइनस 14
28,000
So absolute change we have computed, simply we need to calculate percentage change. 4 by 16 means 1 by 4 and 1 by 4 means 25% है ना.
25
हाँ. 1,40,000 divide by 3 lakh solve it. 1,40,000 divide by 3 lakh or 140 divide by 300 or 14 divide by 30 solve it.
Forty-six point six seven percent.
Okay, then compute 540 divided by 1900.
Sir, 28.42%.
28.42%. Then 2 by 6, matlab 1 by 3, means 33.33%. Then 2 by 2 means 1 by 1. Means 100%. Then 100 by 80 means 5 by 4. 5 by 4. 125%. Correct. Very good. Then 5 lakh divided by 880. 500 divided by 880. Solve it.
56.82.
How much?
56.81%
Then 40,000 divided by 10,20,000.
3.92. Yes, sir.
3.92% 3.92% 3.92% So I hope the question is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children. In this question only one thing is different, that is to calculate other expense. How other expense is computed? 6 plus 2, 8 lakh. Then it's 10%, 80,000. 8 plus 4, 12 lakh. Then it's 15%, 1,80,000. This was the point which was extra in this question.